Hi guys, it's me again, Mr. Daly, your favorite slash only darkroom photography teacher. Today I'm going to talk about loading cameras, okay? There are two basic types of cameras. You have a manual camera, which means you manually load it, advance it, and unload it. And then an automatic camera means the camera will automatically load it after you put the film in it, advance it, and rewind it, okay? The manual camera we'll start with first, but let's go back to the film cassettes. The cassettes that I give you are reusable, okay? And the store-bought film is not reusable, all right? If you have store-bought film, in order to open it, you would have to have a bottle opener like so, and then I'll show you in the darkroom the opener that's mounted on the wall right when you go into the darkroom to the right. You just slide the flat end of it into the metal bracket and pry it down. Sometimes it takes a couple times, and then you can pull it apart with your fingers. But you will never be able to get this open, we'll never say never, without ripping your nails off the store-bought one, okay? But I will provide you film, and there's two different types of cassettes. The plain one for cameras that don't need a barcode, but some cameras need a barcode, and so that's what these are for. All right, so loading the camera. With a manual camera, you're going to typically, on the back side, you're going to pull the left knob up, which is the rewinder knob. All the mechanics, the shutter speed is typically over here, and the advancer is over here as well as the shutter release button. So right here, I'm just going to pull this up all the way so that it undoes the hatch. Open up your camera, knock some stuff over. Now, I load the camera this way because it's just what I'm comfortable with doing. I point this way. My concern is that if you put body weight on this, you could break it. But this is just the way that I do it. However you do it is up to you. So this needs to be up all the way. And you're going to take the knob end of your film cassette down. The emulsion side of the film is the dull kind of greener side. The non-emulsion is the kind of dull gray purple side. So the emulsion side needs to go down facing the shutter. So the knob end of the cassette drops in, and pull that up so it drops all the way down. And then make sure it's engaged. You'll know because if you spin it, it moves a little bit. Never touch the shutter. So I want to avoid that. So I'm going to pull the film out and away from that and come all the way over. Typically, there are two spools over here. One spool has teeth on it which grab the perforated edge of the film and either move it forward or back into the cassette. And then the other spool has, and again they can vary, this one happens to have three grooves on it. And it's probably difficult to see because the camera's far away and this is all black. It's all black because light has a hard time bouncing off black, flat black. And so the inside of the camera is black. Okay. So I'm going to take this over. I call this the feeder or the J part. So we want that to go into any one of those grooves. And you need to drive it down. Sometimes it'll spin on you, so if you hold your finger there, you can keep it from rotating on you. Drive it in. You can see I'm having a little difficulty, so don't get frustrated. Drive it in as far as it can go. I need to look at it this way. That's why I'm struggling. So that should be good. And now you have to release the shutter in order to advance it. Okay, so it's got it, but it's not enough. This, if I close this now, chances are this will kick out. And you'll think you're shooting pictures, and you're not, because the film isn't moving. It'll feel gritty if that's the case, and that's typically because the teeth on that spool, instead of grabbing the film and moving it, they're kind of just going. So if you feel it feel kind of crunchy or gritty, you did something wrong, okay? So what I want to do is make sure that this film, I can now see the emulsion side, tucks behind the spool. So I'm going to go ahead and advance it another time. Now it cannot pop back out. I've also exposed all this film, so that film is gone, okay? It's overexposed. So now what I do is this is just me. I put my fingers on these teeth so the film doesn't move. And see, it's kind of got a little bit of play there. I want to get rid of that slack. So I just rewind it. And now it grabs the film. And it won't rewind because it's not released, but it will flatten that film. Okay? You don't want to rip the film or worse, break your camera. So I'm just going to hold it so it's flat, then I close it, and then I let go, and you may see some movement as the film opens up back into the cassette. Then, we need to get rid of that exposed film, so I'm gonna take one, two exposures. Chances are I still have some exposed film in there, and that's why I personally just take the first picture twice. And that's how you load a manual camera. Now, you're taking pictures, and then all of a sudden it stops. It will not let you take any more. That means it's done. Don't force it, you'll rip the film, or again, worse, break the camera. So once it's done, it's done, okay? So at that point, I need to rewind the film. Here is a rewind knob that has an arrow on it, and this particular one has a little handle, so I want to rewind it. However, it won't let me. That spool that had the teeth on it that's holding the film needs to be released and allowed to go backwards. So on the bottom, typically, of the camera is a button. I'm going to push that button in, it releases that spool, and I can then begin rewinding. Now you'll feel a little bit of tension, but what you can also do is listen. I heard a click. That means that film hit the back of the camera. The only reason I would do that is when I go to roll film, which is another video we've done, I can cut this if I'd like, so I have a nice flat surface to load into the reel. But you do not need to do that, okay? That is how you load a manual camera, alrighty? Alright, loading the automatic cameras. Typically, the latch will be on the left side of the, when looking at the back of your camera, and this one happens to be right there, and you push it down, and that will open up the camera. As I said earlier, the inside of the camera, for the most part, is flat black, so light doesn't bounce around and or then ruin your exposure. So this particular camera has an orange knob that this knob will go down to. So the film, you always want the emulsion side, again, which is the gray-green side facing the shutter, and the knob always goes down. So I'm going to kind of scoop it down, okay, and then if I look over here on this particular camera, it says film on it in black. You're not going to be able to see it from there. Most of them will have another orange marker there indicating where the film goes in. They can be very sensitive, so you got to take it right to where it says film. So I need to look at this closely, pull some film out, be careful of the shutter. Tear there. That's just because this is demo film. You shouldn't have that situation arise, but that's why it was stuck there a little bit. So I need to go right to where that film line is. And again, they can be super sensitive, so I'm making sure that it's right to it. And I'm going to go ahead and close the camera, turn it on. And this particular camera is flashing 400 because it didn't have a barcode on it. So it's telling me, hey, I don't know the speed of the film that's ISO, but I'm going to set it 400, and that's what we use, so that's good. Some of your cameras, you'll have to check them, and they can all vary, so I'm not going to demonstrate that. You'll see me individually. But that's it. It's loaded it. This one counted it out. It says it's got 19 exposures, and it will start to count down as I take pictures, 18, 17, 16. So I'm going to continue doing that, which normally I would not want to do because it does eat battery. And then once it's done, because this is counted backwards, it's really not going to rewind the film because it is, in a sense, rewinding it. It did pull the rest of it back into the cassette. When I open it, all the film has been sucked into it, and it is ready to develop. And that's it for the automatic cameras.